tell you how it all started. In the NAVC board meeting, you know, I talked about, we were gonna do a telethon, I told the board. And the suggestion came out from this board with an NCA member sitting in there. Why don't we leverage our programs and if we have an opportunity to play charity game and then take all the money and give it to charity? And I'm like, wow, what a great idea that is. And so you saw there have been some games. The Kansas-Missouri game was the biggest. In our case, we looked at it and said, one, we don't want to pay for travel. So when you did the game, if two teams went together, if they went to a court, you had to pay for their travel, and if they had to stay overnight, they could not miss class, all that kind of stuff. Well, we said, well, let's do it in state. Let's get somebody in state that will come to us, and then it was, we're gonna do something in state. We're gonna do Preston, who has been a part of our staff and has done a great job at Moorhead. So we just said, let's do that. We called him, and he said, well, we're in. What's the date? And we gave him some dates, and we came up with a date to do this. And so that's how we got here. So what do you think?
Well, it's obviously a great opportunity for us. I really appreciate the coach reaching out and thinking of us to be a part of this and to partner for a great cause. It's one of those situations where everybody wins. You know, coach has got 8 new players. I have 10, obviously my first full season, and opportunity for our kids. We have 5 in-state kids, 5 Kentucky kids on our roster, and so they dream of playing in that building, and it's obviously a great atmosphere and good opportunity for them to do that. And obviously charity is going to be the big winner. I think Team Rubicon is the charity we're going with, which is really neat. An opportunity to use our sport, use our game to really give back is special.
You know, we're also having, you can text if you're not at the game or if you're at the game, and I believe it's 8787.
878-72.
72.
Yeah, text Kentucky Cares, KY Cares.
Kentucky Cares, 878-72. We're releasing more tickets today. The students are picking up tickets. We've purchased 2,000 tickets. You know, and again, the reason we did it is, why should the students, again, they're students. If they've already given, they don't need to give again. If they want to go to the game, that's good for us. It adds to the game, which adds to the charity, and for them to get down there and do all that. So we've put tickets aside. I would tell them that they said there was a line out there today to get those tickets. So if you're a student and you want those tickets, you know, I would get them sooner than later. But anybody that comes to the game, if it's a $10 seat, a $20 seat, a $250 seat with your feet on the wood, it's gonna be important. There's no TV. Both of us said we're not giving the tape to any fans, so no one will see this game unless you're in that building. So you have to be in the building to see it. It's the first Division I game we play this year. We're not ready to play. I imagine he's not ready to play. Your team, we're both in the same boat. But it'll be a great benchmark for anybody that watches the game to say, all right, when we start playing early on, how far have they come? Because, like our non-conference schedule, I mean, we're looking at teams that, from, you know, Illinois, Chicago to Vermont, everybody doesn't understand that they're like a top 50 RPI team. I mean, I'm not sure we can be the top 50 RPI team right now. You have to have out-of-bounds plays. You have to have a press attack. You have to have a zone offense. You have to, what if we need a 3? We have none of that right now. We're just trying to stay in the stands for 30 seconds. So you get a chance to see us, no television, and it's for charity, a great cause. And when we talk about the Rubicon, they are giving money to also California. And you had thousands of people had their homes burned. You know, you're talking about Puerto Rico, 20% have electricity right now. I just talked to somebody about Virgin Islands. They say the Virgin Islands was basically wiped out. I know I was talking to the director of HUD, who oversees that this state and the Virgin Islands and Puerto Rico. She told me yesterday, Denise Leggett, that Virgin Islands was wiped out. So, because it gets farther and farther away from us, you think Houston doesn't need help, or some spots in Florida don't need help. They still need help. And it's going to be ongoing. So for us to be able to leverage both of our programs and have our fans become a part of this, and this is on top of the $1 million we already raised for the telethon. Most of that went to Texas. So, questions?
Do you have an estimate or a goal for how much money you guys are going to be able to raise on that?
I'm thinking because of how we're doing this, it's probably going to be about $500,000. That would be my guess. If there are anybody, businesses want to do any matching dollars to this, they want to give to California or wherever else, and they want to match some money that we're raising here, I would encourage businesses to, you know, stand up, or any individuals that are looking at this stuff on the TV and feel bad. This is a great way to do it. Call the university and say, hey, I'm going to match money that you're raising. I'm going to give you X amount of dollars to go as a match to what you've raised. It would be neat if we had that. But my guess is about $500,000.
Cal, do you think that the NCAA should let you do this every year? This could be something that programs can do annually, this a third exhibition per year?
I do. And you know, my thing would be, look, I think we should play exhibition games anyway. You know I've said that. Why aren't we playing exhibition games? And if you play them, the university has their budgets to meet, but an extra game like this to charity, I just think it's a good way for our programs and athletics to give back. It's a great way for our kids. The telethon that we've done over the years, it's as much the things we do at Christmas where we bring in families. Yes, we're doing that for those families and these victims, but do you understand what it does for an 18 or 19 year old to be able to give a family a check? See that mother cry, like, in their arms. To be able to get these kids to understand, you're going to be in a position to leverage who you are and what you're about to help others. Do it. The telethons, the kids answering the phones, and Kevin Knox got $2,000 donations. He was so proud. I mean, that's why we do this. As much as it's for who we're doing it for, these kids need to feel this. That's why Marcus Cousins got the latest Community Assist Award. John Wall obviously got it last season. Anthony Davis is, you know, our kids get that.